Oh, wow, Mary, an old taupe.
Oh, it's a taupe shark.
Yeah?
Yeah.
This is very old, you realise that?
Oh, is it?
Yeah, a good 100 years plus.
How do you tell that?
The fact that the taxidermy is a bit primitive by the shape, it's just basically been stuffed.
Oh, OK, it hasn't been put on a primitive, but
yeah, an anatomically correct body or anything like that. It's just been skinned and packed out, so to speak. I haven't seen one before, and I think it's a very unusual piece.
It's certainly striking, isn't it?
It's a one-off, yes.
The golden age of taxidermy was during the Victorian era, when English ornithologist John Hancock created a series of stuffed birds for the Great Exhibition of 1851. Audiences were wowed by the chance to see rare and exotic animals up close, and his display sparked a national interest in taxidermy, with amateur and professional collections springing up around the country.
Chris has got to be really careful. The shark is obviously old. It looks old. It needs a lot of work doing on it, but it needs to be done to a really high standard, otherwise I'm not going to make my money back. So Chris is going to have his work cut out. Paid £150.
To be honest with you, I probably would have bought it for that. Just purely because it's so unusual.
Brilliant.
It's a one-off and it's so old, it's worth preserving and giving it another new lease of life.
It's all yours. Bye, taupe.
Thanks,
bye,
Mary. I'll see you in a few weeks.
Bye.
Bye-bye. I've worked on a lot of weird and wonderful objects over my years of restoring things, but nothing quite like this, I have to say. We've got to keep it as it was to keep its value there, because people want things natural, and this is how taxidermy was done in those days. Why alter that? This is a statement in time.
Back in Northamptonshire, Chris has the shark on his workbench. He's wrapped the fins in damp cloth overnight to see if they can be softened up and straightened out.
There we go. It's softened up quite nicely. So I think I've got a chance of clamping these fins either side, and with a very light tissue paper and a backing glue, I can repair these frayed edges. Simple process. Find the right sized piece of veneer. I would put various bits on and basically some bulldog clips. That's it. Simple as that.
The fins are left to dry out, and in the meantime, Chris turns his attention to the damage around the shark's gills.
That's better. We can get inside it now and see how the fish was actually filled. And if I... There we go. That coming out is basically a very hard, compact sawdust.
Chris uses a wooden adhesive to glue the gills back in position. Once he's happy with the positioning, he has an epoxy filler putty, which he'll use to fill the cracks.
I'm not just going to smooth it just over the damage. I want to get some underneath it so as it's going to bond. And obviously with the strength of this stuff, once that's dried out, it will prevent any more cracking. Now this stuff dries really solid, but I can actually sand it and use a scalpel on it to thin it down. But we don't want perfection on this. It's lumpy bumpy, the thing, and that is fine. I'm going to literally leave it as that.
There's a long way to go with the shark's body, and Chris has yet to get started on a display case that will show it off in all its glory. Back in Northamptonshire, taxidermist Chris is working on dealer Mary's 100-year-old taupe shark. Following her trip to Cardiff, she's asked Chris to make a display case that's true to the spirit of Victorian taxidermy with a naturalistic setting. He's replaced the plain wooden plank with a new MDF base that will form the bottom of the case.
This gives me the chance to be really creative, bringing the fish and a nice base together, which will turn the whole thing into a scene. So what I want to do is get a bit more undulating, a bit more dips and raises. It just makes the base look as though it's a seabed and not just a flat surface.
A basic papier-mâché mix using PVA glue and newspaper will allow Chris to begin to build up the seabed effect.
Now, I tend to do this as a... just play it along and see how it goes. So I'm scrunching up a bit of paper, and I will just literally press it on there and as it starts drying, I can push it down. So we're starting to put a bit of shape into the base. It's taken away this flatness.
A couple of hours later, it's time to check the papier-mâché.
This has dried enough for me to start practicing colour in the rocks. Usually do it two or three times. As it dries out, I just try various options on it. My initial start is to see what it looks like with a basic grey colour, so it's going to tone with the fish. Literally, I'm just going to use watercolours, can use acrylics. Even I mix up emulsion paints. Gives it a little bit of a sort of stippled effect, so the rock has got some shape to it.
Victorian taxidermists would traditionally use items from nature to build up their display. And Chris has a few ideas to make his seabed look more realistic.
I'm seeing the final display. Now we're starting to work on this. So I think the next stage will be to put some sand down and start burying a bit of broken shell in there, maybe a bit of seaweed on, just see what it looks like. So what I'm going to do is back to the PVA. I'm going to spread this over. I'm going to take it up into the recesses so it looks like we've got, you know, a proper seabed. Yeah, we've got a bucket of dried out sand. And I'm literally going to scatter it. And also, along with just the sand, I will put some larger pebbles in. And this is where your creative skills come out. Tomorrow, when the PVA is dried, then I can just tone all the rocks in as I want and just throw on some more sand, and then I stand back in complete awe, or not.
Hi, Chris.
Mary, good to see you.
Good to see you too, and it's very good to see this. Come on, let's have a look. Whoa! Blimey! That's amazing!
Do you actually recognise him?
He's had a bit of a makeover, I have to say. He looks a lot more handsome. It's, what? Like, so much better than I would ever have imagined. It's incredible. But I love this kind of seascape you've done at the bottom.
You know,
it's still got age to it, hasn't it?
Yeah. I love the character of it, and I think it's brought it all out now.
Well, you're an artist, I'd have to say.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's not just a simple case of just redoing the fish. You've created an artistic, amazing environment for it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a stunning, stunning thing.
When it arrived, this worn-out taupe shark looked anything but lifelike and was crudely mounted on an uninspiring plank of wood. Chris has spent hours delicately restoring the shark's coloration and features so it looks more realistic. And the seabed display scene he's constructed places it back in its natural habitat.
You've got the case as well, which I'm super impressed with, by the way, but I love the way that you've painted it in that kind of grey colour, which reflects on the rocks and, of course, the shark.
This has just been put together out of an acrylic, out of the perspex. And obviously, with the perspex, kids can't come along and break a fin off. You know, people can't touch it. And it keeps the weight down and
it keeps it a lot safer. I know, I see what it's perfect. It just looks so natural and really tastefully done. I don't think we'll see one like this again, that's for sure.
I don't think so.
Especially now he's been preserved and saved and he's happy in his new home. What I like the most about what Chris has done is that he's created this amazing environment for the shark. He's even gone to the effort of, like, building rocks, but it just looks so authentic, so genuine. It could actually be Victorian to me.
What do you think if I said I wanted about
1,500 for it?
I don't see that as being unrealistic at all. In the right setting, I think it'd be worth every penny.
Oh, brilliant news. Thank you. I'm just over the moon with it.
I have enjoyed working on this purely because when I saw it initially, I just thought, I've never been brought anything like this before. This is a complete one-off, and I'll probably never see one again. So, yeah, I'm really, really happy with it.